Swayam Prabha, Digital India, Educated India.
Namaskar and a very warm welcome to you all to this second class in our second lecture series on Japanese language and culture. So, as you all know, we are going to be revising this week whatever we have done in our previous lecture series. So, in our first class, we have done particle wa, particle mo, particle no. If I am not mistaken, a little bit of particle O as well. Then we have also covered question words like dare, then nan, then ikura, which is for asking price. We have also done words like koresore are, which show and point at a certain object, or konosono ano, which is also used for living things, kono hon. So, we have already covered all this. Now, let us see what we have here in this lesson. So, well, as you can see, we are going to revise time. But before doing time, I want to do particle O with you. Now, particle O, as you did last time, was something O kudasai, noun O kudasai, which means please give this to me. Today I'll show you other usages of O, and one of them is it's used as a prefix, and that means that it expresses politeness. It is used to show respect and can be used with nouns, verbs, adjectives. So, well, you know these words already. Onamae. O Namae. So, now when you are asking somebody, then you will use this O Namae. Now, this is not a particle, please remember. O is a particle. What we did earlier in our previous lesson, this is a particle and this is an honorific. This O is not used with family members. So, when someone asks you your name, then you will say Namae wa, and when you ask somebody, it is always O Namae. Then also you have shigoto over here. Watashi wa shigoto o shimasu. Now this O over here is particle O, but this O again is honorific. So when you are asking somebody O shigoto wa nan desu ka, then this is honorific, polite. Now we can also use it with verbs, as I just now told you, o ai shimashita. Now, this o ai is sensei ni o ai shimashita. Again, used with teachers, used with people who are older in age or rank, or in formal situations. Ohanashi shimashita. Sensei to ohanashi shimashita. Or sensei wa ohanashi mashita. Now, if you are talking to your teacher, you are talking to your boss, seniors, then o isogashi desu ka? And if it is about you, you will say hai watashi wa isogashi desu. Or sensei kara o denwa ga arimashita. So again, this is all polite. So the sound is the same. Now there are certain words in Japanese which already have o in it. So for example, you have okane. So, okane already has the O in it. O-ka-ne. Okay. And then onaka. So, it is not naka for stomach. It is onaka for stomach. O, na, and ka. Then you have some other honorifics also, like gohan. Now you will not say for food han o kudasai. No, you will say gohan. So go is already in the word now, and it is used as a normal Japanese word. Gojusho. When you ask somebody, gojusho wa nan desu ka? And for yourself, watashi no jusho wa, whatever your jusho is. So, go is honorific, and without the go, jusho is humble or normal conversation. Go shinsetsu ni. Go shinsetsu ni, very kindly. So, somebody else, go shinsetsu ni yatte kuremashita. He did something very, very nicely. And go yukkuri. So, if you have to request somebody to talk slowly, then go yukkuri hanashite kudasai. Please talk very slowly. Watashi wa nihongo ga wakaranai kara. Go yukkuri hanashite kudasai. Or when it is about you, then watashi wa yukkuri hanashimasu kara shimpai shinai de kudasai. Please don't worry. I will talk very slowly. So, this is particle O. And this is just O, which is honorific, which is a prefix. Now, we will do particle O over here. As I told you in your previous lecture, particle O marks direct object. And what does it mean? It means that the verb which follows O is directly acting on the noun. Now, how does that happen? Let us see. For example, you have ringo o tabemasu. So, noun is over here. This is particle o and this is the verb. So, what is the action of this verb on the noun? It is to eat. So, there is a direct relationship between the noun and the verb, directly acting on the noun. So, in such a case, you will use particle O, and this is particle O and not the honorific O, please. Pronunciation is the same. Watashi wa ringo o tabemasu. Now, in place of ringo, you can use other words as well. Let us see what those can be. So, kaban. And what do you do with the kaban? You buy a kaban. So, watashi wa kaban o kaimasu, or gohan o tabemasu. So, you just now saw go is the honorific over here, but it is already in the word, so we will use it as gohan. Then, ega o, ega is pictures, so ega o mimasu. And nihongo o benkyo shimasu. So, you will see always particle o will come because there is a direct relationship over here between noun and verb. Now, there are a lot of ways you can use O in the language. Now, let us see what those are. O is also used with motion verbs. You can see over here where there is some action happening or you are moving in a certain direction. Basically, there are three motion verbs in Japanese which you know: iku, kuru, and kairu. But there are also some other verbs which show some kind of motion where you are passing through a certain space. For example, you are crossing a ground, or you are crossing a bridge, or you are crossing a corridor, you are passing through a corridor, or as in this one, watashi wa sora o tobimasu. So, I am passing through the sora, I am flying across, I am flying in the sora is the meaning. This is an exception over here. Then you will understand it better with this. Tsuru wa sora o tonde Siberia kara Indo ni kimasu. So, tsuru is crane, wa sora o tonde, flying through the sora, and Siberia kara, from Siberia, Indo ni kimasu, comes to India. So, over here, you will see that the meaning is it is flying over and coming. These are all special cases, so you can just memorize them as such. There is a lot of grammar, but when speaking, grammar is a little difficult to remember, so just remember it like that. There is more, as I just now told you, khashi o, watari, maso, cross over, go across. Then hashi is bridge, then indo de kuruma wa michi no hidari gawa o hashirimasu. In India, kuruma, which is cars, wa michi no hidari gawa, on the left side, hashirimasu, they move, they run basically. Hashirimasu is to run, so they move. So over here also you will see that O is there. Gawa will be covered later, so you just remember it as hidari gawa, meaning on the left side. Now O can be used in a lot of other ways as well. We will do those later. Now how to ask and how to tell time. So you have a small picture over here of this watch which says it is 7 o'clock. So ima, now, nanji desu ka? That is the question. Nan is the question word, which means what, and nanji, ji is the counter for time. Okay, ji is the counter used for time. Desu and ka. Ka is the question word. So what is the time now? Ima shichi ji desu. Desu you can take from here. If you have the needle here, pointing here, then what is the time? Ima hachi ji desu. So you will notice that ji counter is coming after time. Ima ji shichi desu? No, ima shichi ji desu. So ji counter for time is going to follow the digit of time. Now there is another one for you over here. This says 4:15. So ima nanji desu ka? Ima nanji desu ka? So well, you can say, if it was over here, then ima yoji desu. But it is showing over here, which is quarter past 4 or 4:15. So what do we say now? Yoji, yoji, ju, go, hun desu. So the counter for minutes is hun, hun pun. Now if it was pointing at, say, here, then yoji, it is 35. So yoji, yoji, sanju, sanju, which is 30, go hun desu. Is it okay? So please remember, counter for time is ji and counter for minutes is hun and hun. So ippun, nihun, sampun, yohun, gohun, roppun, nanahun, happun, kyuhun, juppun, juippun, junihun. Again it starts. So you can take it till 60. I think this is clear now. You can practice once again. It is 3:40. So what are you going to say? Sanji, sanji, yonju, pun desu. Sanji, yonju, pun desu. This is how you will say. If it is 3:05, then sanji, gohun desu. Sanji gohun desu. You can practice like this for 10, 15, 20, 25, 30 and memorize your minutes and time. Now how will you say it is 3:30 or it is 4:30? So how will you say this? The word for 30 or half is han. So if it is 3:30, you will say sanji han des. If it is 4:30, you will say yoji han des. Please remember one thing over here, that this digit 4 has a number of readings. It is yo for time, it is yon and shi for number. So over here you will not write yon ji des. No, it is yo ji des. Shi is used for shi gatsu, which is the counter for months. So shigatsu is April. It is not yogatsu. Yogatsu? No, it will be shigatsu. So you have to remember where to use yon, where to use yo, and where to use shi. And the word for half is han in time. Then if it was pointing, this was pointing here, then it is quarter to five. How will you say quarter to five? So, goji, jugo hun, mae desu. Mae means before. So, it's 15 minutes before five. In a similar manner, if it is 3:45, how will you say quarter to four? So quarter to four will be yoji jugohun mae desu. So this will be this over here. Please remember, practice it like this so it will be easy for you to tell time. Now this is the kanji for han. You are cutting these three lines with a sword. So all don't break, only this one, the first one breaks like this. So cutting it like this with a sword. So this is how it is written, like this. This means han. This is a sword, cutting three lines with a sword, and this is what you get. Now, how will you tell AM and PM? So well, gogo is PM and the kanji for gogo is like this, 1, 2, 3 and then 1, 2, 3 and 1, 2 and 3. So go means noon and this means ato or later. So after noon is PM. So ima nanji desu ka? Ima gogo, as is given over here, gogo. Yoji han. You just now did han. You can do it similarly for 5:30. So ima nanji desu ka? Ima gogo goji han desu. So you can practice for all the others. 2:30, 5:30, 7:30, and you can add gogo over here and practice. Ask and answer. Now, how will you say AM? AM is gozen. Gozen. Now, how is gozen written in kanji? Well, go is just the same. Go is noon. So, before noon is, this is noon and this is before or earlier. So before noon will be AM. So if instead of gogo it is before or early in the morning, then it will be gozen. So AM and PM. Now how will you say that we perform a certain activity at a certain time? So basically, how will you say in, at and on? So what is the particle to be used? The particle is particle ni. Now this is a new particle. Ni has numerous functions to perform. One of them is telling that at a certain time a certain activity is happening or is being done. So watashi wa gozen rokuji ni okimasu. Get up. So rokuji is time over here. You can see at 6 o'clock I get up. Gozen rokuji, am rokuji. A simple construction. Instead of watashi, you can have anyone, any other noun. Otosan, okasan, imoto, tomodachi. You can also have sensei. Wa gozen rokuji ni okimasu. Otosan gets up at 6 o'clock in the morning. Sensei gets up at 6 o'clock in the morning. Over here, instead of okimasu, you can put any other verb, which is tabemasu or ikimasu or nemasu. And for time, you can again put whatever time you want. For example, watashi wa rokuji ni, and here you can add gogo, rokuji ni gohan o tabemasu. Or mainichi hachiji ni kaisha e ikimasu. So you can replace all these and make numerous sentences, ask and answer. So now you can see time ni verb. That's the pattern. At a certain time, a certain activity is happening. So watashi wa rokuji ni gohan o tabemasu, as I have already written for you over here. So now let us do words for location. We have already done kono sono ano and kore sore are, which is used for showing objects. Okay. How will you tell that a certain person or a certain thing is present at a certain place? Okay. So let us see what the question word is and what the other words are for location. Now, boshi wa doko desu ka? That's the question word for location. Where? Boshi wa doko desu ka? Where is the boshi, which is cap? So now what are the words for location? Koko, soko, asoko and doko. It's the same koso ado series. Koko stands for here, soko stands for there, asoko over there and doko where, as you have done for kono sono ano and kore sore are, which stands for things. Now, if you have this question, boshi wa doko desu ka? So, well, he is pointing at it and saying boshi wa koko desu, which is close to the speaker and far away from the listener. Okay? Over here, you can see. Now, you have boshi also over here. So, boshi wa doko desu ka? Boshi wa koko desu. One and two. This person can also say boshi wa asoko desu, because it is far away from the speaker and the listener both. A and B, this is koko, this is soko for this person, and if something is over here, then it is asoko, as is the case over here, far away from both of them. Now, jitensha wa doko desu ka? Jitensha wa asoko desu. Now, Tanaka-san wa doko desu ka? Now, this is for person, hito. Tanaka-san wa doko desu ka? Tanaka-san wa asoko desu. He is pointing. He is far away from listener and speaker both. So, Tanaka-san wa asoko desu. Somewhere far away from these two people. So, the words for showing location is koko, as I just wrote down, soko and asoko, and the question word is doko. Now Empitsu or hon wa koko desu. So what is the question? Empitsu wa doko desu ka? Or hon wa doko desu ka? Hon wa koko desu. Or you can also say hon wa soko desu if you are far away from the book. Empitsu wa koko desu or empitsu wa soko desu if you are far away from the object. Tanaka-san wa asoko desu, which we did just now in our previous slide. So, asoko desu. Now, you have shown existence of a certain thing at a certain place. You have shown it with the be verb desu. This is not a complete verb as we all know. It cannot perform a lot of functions a verb should perform. So, what is the verb that we are going to use in place of desu? And what is the particle? As I told you that ni performs a lot of functions in the language. One you did with time and now you are doing it with location. What does it do? So, well, tokei wa koko ni arimasu. Now, arimasu is a verb which shows existence of a certain object at a certain place. Presence of a certain object. And the place is marked by particle ni. So, koko ni over here, tokei arimasu. Tokei is present. To show presence of inanimate things, arimasu is used. Now, instead of tokei, again, you can have any noun, enpitsu or pen or hon, anything you can have. Wa koko ni arimasu. So, presence of an object at a certain place. Or soko ni arimasu. Soko ni arimasu or asoko. Any of these you can use. Now, when you have to show presence of a person, for example, sensei, hito, otosan, otosan, okasan, tomodachi, Tanaka-san. Well, you have to use the word imasu, imasu, which shows presence of a certain person at a certain place. Now, the place is again marked by particle ni. Ni shows existence at that place. So, instead of kurasu, you can have gakko, uchi, kaisha, depato, etc. Any place can be mentioned and then imasu, imasu. So, you can practice like this. Otosan wa gakko ni imasu or watashi wa gakko ni imasu. And then again, if you want to say that nobody is present over there or he is not present over there, then imasen can be used. Now, we will do days of the week and see how ni is used with days of the week. We have done time, we have done arimasu and imasu, existence of people and objects at a certain place. So, watashi wa kinyobi ni, over here on kinyobi, kimasen or kimasen. So, on a certain day, I do a certain thing or I do not do a certain thing. Particle ni is always used. Please remember in, at and on particle ni. Then the days of the week are given over here. Getsuyobi, kayobi, suyobi, mokuyobi, doyobi and nichiyobi. Kinyobi is already mentioned over here. You could have special days like Diwali or Holi or Christmas. Ni, always ni. I go or I come or I do a certain activity, but always particle ni. Then on specific dates. So, hapyo wa 15 nichi ni arimasu. Hapyo is on 15th. Diwali is on 15th. Diwali wa jugonichi desu. Shiken kekkon shiki. Kekkon shiki is marriage. Shiken is test. Hapyo is presentation. Anything can be on a certain date. Ju ni nichi ni arimasu. Ju san nichi ni arimasu. So you will see particle ni is being used again after dates. So day, date and time. Particle ni. So you can practice with your partner also like this. Kogi, kaigi, party, shiken. Kaigi is meeting, kogi is lecture, party you already know. So what date you can ask and then answer. The dates are also given very clearly. And now we will do some kanji. You have done this kanji of gozen, go and zen, which I already told you. Now you can see the pictogram over here, how it has come. This is the kitchen. So, in olden times, as there was no light, the lady of the house would want to make food before nightfall. So, before the moon rises, well, let me finish all my work, let me cut all the vegetables. So, it's coming from moon and the knife. So, I'll make it once again for you. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is noon and then 1, 2, 3. On top something is kept, vegetables are kept. This is moon and then this is the knife part. So that's how the idea of gozen has come into being. Then we have gogo. I also made this for you. So again, go is again noon and then like this, this and then this. This also means ato or later. So you can see this man walking backwards. He is walking, looking behind and then walking. So that is ato, later. And you can see the cross section, that's how it looks, with his head over here, hands and the feet. Both are 9-stroke characters. And then you have ato. Reading is ato. Once again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Well, you can see how proportionately this is written. Write it like this. Then, another reading for this is ushi ro means behind. So, you can see this kanji is coming again and again and I think you will be able to memorize it. Now, there are some similar looking characters over here. This is go, you did just now. And now this is ushi, which is cow. And the only difference is that it goes right till top. This stops over here. Please remember this is go. And this is ushi, which is a cow. Now you have this character, which is fun or pun. And it is also used for cutting, which is wakeru. And then we have ima, which means that you are in a hut, singing something, that's the pictogram. This signifies house or a roof and you can say this is ra. So this means ima. That's the pictogram that you have for this character. Now for six, this is roku, very, very simple. We have done in the first lesson. So roku and this is hachi and it is shown with four fingers of one hand and four fingers of the other in Chinese, hachi. Very similar looking kanji, so please do this. Then we have time, which is toki, also used for G, counter for time. So, ichi, G, like this. Okay, ichi, G. Now, this is also very similar to this, but a different meaning. This is otera, which is a temple. Now, why do we use this tera kanji with G? Well, in olden times, this is the pictogram. In olden times, every 1 hour, the otera bell would ring to inform people about the time. And this over here signifies day, coming from the sun, which is this. So then every day, every hour, the bell would toll and people would know from the villages what time it is. So this kanji is associated with time. This is the pictogram. You can see the otera, the hand pointing, the sun over here, and finally this kanji into being. Now I would like to tell you something about temples also. In Japan, you have the Shinto temples and the Buddhist temples or the oteras. So, a Shinto temple, which is called a jinja, and this would be an otera. You can see from the picture also that this is nice and bright and this is little subdued or little dull colors, mainly brown and generally dull colors in the otera, in the Buddhist temples. Now, this is very bright and this is called a tori gate. It's orange in color, orange and black, and looks more lively. This is more quiet and solemn over here. Now, in jinjas, you will generally see that there is a lot of color, there is more life. The method of praying is by clapping when you enter. You clap two times and then you enter. And in an otera, you're very quiet. Prayers are offered very silently. Very solemn atmosphere is there in oteras. And also, graveyards are there in oteras. And all happy events are mainly happening in the Shinto shrines, which is called jinja. Now, otera will always have a G after the name of the otera. Generally, G will be used and over here, Ja will be used. The kanji will be for Ja and the kanji will be for G, which is a different kanji. So, this kanji. So, please remember, this is quite interesting. You can read on the net also. There is a lot of information about this. And of course, the basic style of jinja and otera is different. Generally, jinjas will have this gate and oteras are in this pagoda style. These are some differences that you will notice in otera and jinja. Now, this is homework for you. I have just told you about the days of the week. They are all jumbled up. So, I want you to write the readings for these characters here mentioned and the actual meanings of these characters. So, with this, I would like to finish the class here. We will quickly go over what we have done. We have done particle ni today, how to tell that you perform a certain activity at a certain time, then how to use with day, date and time, then existence of people and things, animate and inanimate, by using particle ni, and the verb imas and arimas. Then we have also done location verbs like koko, soko, asoko, and the question word doko, how to ask where a certain person or a certain thing is. And also we have done some new kanjis and some similar looking kanjis. So with this, I would like you to go home, digest all this, revise it and come prepared for your next class where we are going to do some new things and something that I mentioned here, which is time expressions. So, we'll cover those next time. Till then, namaskar and we'll meet again soon. Mata ashita aimashou.